Very respected Dr. P. Shyamaraju, Chancellor and Founder of Reva University. Dr. M. Dhanarajya, Vice Chancellor, Reva University. Padma Bhushan, Dr. Chandrasekhar Kamba. Dr. V. Ravi Chandran, Dr. N. Ramesh, Registrar. Sri Umesh S. Raju, Trustee. And all the invitees and distinguished guests and faculty members and my dear students, a very good evening to all of you. At the outset, I would like to thank Chancellor, Board of Governors and Management of Reva University and the jury members in recognizing me for this prestigious award. Indeed, it's a great honor to receive this Reva Lifetime Achievement Award in the presence of such distinguished gathering. When we look at our country's progress, the status of our science and technology development makes the difference. Great visionaries of our country has envisaged this growth requirement in science and technology. I was fortunate to join almost 36 years before to DRDO under the guidance of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam as director, wherein which I could get the opportunity to work with the missile systems, development of the strategic missile system, the Agni series, and then contribute towards the nation's defense capability. Starting the journey from there as a guidance and mission designer for missiles, moved on to as a project director for Agni 4, which had a quantum jump in technologies, state of art technologies. We all started working 36 years where there was totally technology denial for this class of systems. So it's, we were all working with first of its kind technologies, that is, we need to design, develop, prove. So it goes into iterations. But today's students and the scientific community is fortunate to have some of the advancements in the technologies known to us. So that makes the difference. And when I speak about the Agni 4, there is a quantum jump in technologies. We were initially working of ranges up to 3000, that is Agni 1 to Agni 2 and Agni 3, where 300 kilometers to 3000 kilometers capability. And we were achieving this with 50 ton launch mass, but world across the same category, they were talking about ranges up to 3500. So I was designated to take up total why we are not able to achieve that type of range capability. When we look at the materials used for rocket motor casing, when we convert it from steel to composite materials, I'm talking about the time when composite technology, materials in the composite technology was not available. So first of its kind to start with the indigenous development, time period of within 5 years, we have proven that capability. And Agni 4 with launch mass, which is less than half, that is 22 ton launch mass, and we could achieve 4,000 kilometers. So total redoing of the engineering and then getting the achievements of this nature. Then it was a follow-up for Agni 5. All the technologies were adopted from Agni 4 for a composite, two-stage composite rocket motor. And then we could go with Agni 5 up to 5,000 kilometers. So that is the journey as far as the missile is concerned. Then by 2018, I moved to Director General of Aeronautical Systems, DRDO, at Bangalore, So I got the opportunity to work on aeronautical systems that ranges from the light compact aircraft, LCA and its variants, then on the unmanned aerial vehicles. We are proving our technologies for the military capability on unmanned strikes, and then on the airborne early warning radars, airborne systems as a platform. So these are the type of technology what I could work on and what I could learn from knowing about Reva University is that you have a great visionary chancellor who meticulously plans and does the planning for the university, and you students are really fortunate that the real technical skills and capabilities are given to you. So this is an opportunity for each one of you to take the steps in learning from that and take further. Today is the world of knowledge with respect to the new innovative areas on robotics, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, 3D printing, additive manufacturing, there are quantum computing, smart materials, cognitive technology, and asymmetric technology. You name anything what you think, and there are capability to have visualize these technologies. We all learned from the textbook where technologies were only taught by books. But today it is not like that. You are able to know, understand, and learn things. Today we were fortunate to release the Reva Summit 7, the document wherein which Chancellor was mentioning that we plan it, and then every month that Chancellor takes a review of it and then further takes on. So it is so meticulously done, and this university I'm sure will be doing wonderful things, and already he has given the announcement for the Reva Summit 8 with the theme engage, involve and emerge, and quality education, health and well-being. Being in the pandemic era, that we thought this COVID pandemic will affect us only for 1 year. The second year we thought this year it will be over, but it's still on. So we need to take care of our health along with our studies. I wish I once again take this opportunity to thank the jury members, Chancellor, and the Board of Governors in recognizing for this prestigious award. Thank you, and Jai Hind.